الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه أما بعد رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي يقول الحق تبارك وتعالى وهو أصدق القائلين ومن آياته أن خلق لكم من أنفسكم أزواجا لتسكنوا إليها وجعل بينكم مودة ورحمة الحمد لله. Dear brothers, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us immensely. Inshallah, the khutbah today will be discussing with one of the most important aspects of our life, which is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the sunnah of getting married, and the marriage in Islam, and the state of the marriages in our society today. That will be the khutbah today, inshaAllah ta'ala. Ayyuhal ahbabu fillah, marriage is big ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, big blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where two people come to join one another from different countries, different societies, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His rahmah, out of His signs, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts mawadda and rahmah. Two people from different continents, one from China, the other one from Japan, the other one from America. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا. What is the main reason? لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا. To find sakina, somewhere of rest. We will see the homes of today and the homes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is intending us to have. One of the main purpose of a home, once you get married, is a place of peace and rest. Today, it has completely changed to the opposite. As soon as you enter the home, you want to leave in that minute. Or you want not to come to the home for as many hours as possible. Come while she's only sleeping. And leave to work while she's already she's sleeping. Therefore, the purpose, my dear brothers, for the wife is to provide sakina in the home. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, the purpose is sakina. To be somewhere where you face difficulties, problems and everything. Once you enter the home, you forget everything. But it has turned completely the opposite, my dear brothers. The home became a very difficult place to be. Therefore, my dear brothers, az-zawaj, it is one of the best sunnahs of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And also it is a way of protecting yourself, protecting your private parts, not performing zina, and not going outside of marriage. And also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, getting married, it takes care of half of your deen. Half of your deen is taken care of by getting married. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, He said, مَنْ تَزَوَّجَ فَقَدْ أَحْرَزَ شَطْرَ دِينِهِ. Whoever gets married, he has completed and has taken care of half of his deen. فَلْيَتَّقِ اللَّهَ فِي الشَّطْرِ الْبَاقِي. Therefore, you should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the other half. By getting married, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards you to have taken care of half of your deen. Your eyes would have been taken care of, your ears and your private parts, your tongue. But the opposite, my dear brothers, all the beautiful, sweet words, we want to speak to somebody who's not is our wife. All our eyes, we don't want to use it to enjoy our wives, which is halal. We use it to shop around, look around. Our ears, listening all night, chatting, this, that, the other, the mosquito is at home, my dear brothers. The marriage has completely changed in an opposite direction. Therefore, my dear brothers, Islam made marriage to be ibadah. It's ibadah, taking care of yourself. A salat of somebody who's married, equivalent to somebody who's not married, is almost 70 times. And also it becomes sadaqah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, even sleeping with your wife, enjoying all that, is sadaqah. The sahaba, they said, Ya Rasulallah, you're enjoying with your wife, having all that enjoyment, and you're still getting rewards? He said, what happened if you go and you put it in a haram way, that you get sins,
if you do it in a halal way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala writes ajr for you. Therefore, it is ibadah. Islam, my dear brothers, a beautiful deen, has made, depending on your intention, food becomes ibadah. When you eat, sleeping becomes ibadah. When you sleep, going to the toilet, getting married, depending on your intention. If you put an intention, Ya Allah, I am going to earn halal, to eat so that I can strengthen my body, so that I can do the ibadah, that job becomes ibadah. Going to the toilet, Ya Allah, I am going to perform my tahara, I'm going to perform my wudu, so that I can stand in front of you to worship you, it becomes ibadah. And also, zawaj, if you are getting married, the intention, it is to enlarge the ummah of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to take care of your eyes, your private parts, to protect yourself, it becomes ibadah. Therefore, my dear brothers, even our beautiful deen, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, even your beautiful smile to your Muslim brother becomes ibadah. فَتَبَسُّمُكَ فِي وَجْهِ أَخِيكَ صَدَقَةً. Even a beautiful smile to your Muslim brother becomes ibadah. Therefore, my dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, one of the purpose of our creation is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. How can we change our normal life into ibadah? Al-adatu to ibadah. Through intention. If you intend to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through going to your job, to earn the halal way becomes ibadah. Your food is ibadah. The food that you're feeding your family, Ya Allah, you've made it wajib upon me to feed them. Ya Allah, I'm going to earn for them. Ya Allah, I'm feeding them. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, even the food that you feed your family, your children becomes ibadah. It becomes sadaqah. On your book of deed, you will see that you have given so much sadaqah, majority of it is feeding your family members, which is ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, dear brothers, az-zawaj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought it as a solution. Allah, who has created this body, knows the needs of the body. One of the needs of the body is to all our sexual enjoyment and all these other things, the enjoyment that we need, that our bodies need. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put a woman to complete the man. Az-zawaj, you get together, even sleeping together becomes ibadah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ad-dunya mata'." This dunya is an enjoyment. Wa khayru mata'iha al-mar'atu as-salihah. And the best enjoyment is to have a partner to enjoy with through halal way, sleeping with her. The Islam has changed because preventing you from committing zina. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Wala taqrabu az-zina." Do not even go closer to somewhere zina is performed. But the body needs it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought it zawaj. Zawaj. If you know your daughter is with somebody now in another room, you'll be heartbroken. If you know that somebody says your daughter has got pregnant by somebody who's not married, you'll be heartbroken. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought a solution. Yourself in your own home, you will have somebody with your daughter. And when they tell you, Alhamdulillah, she's pregnant, you will start announcing to everybody. That is the solution that Islam came to protect us and to protect the ummah. Therefore, dear brothers, the wives are of different qualities. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if these four qualities are found in women, they are the best. Look at your wife. If she has some of these, she is amongst the best. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, this dunya is an enjoyment and you need someone to enjoy with. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِذَا نَظَرَ إِلَيْهَا سَرَّتْ. If you look at your wife, you become happy. She's not grumpy, angry, ready to eat you, ready to throw you out, ready to fight with you. Ready in her clothing, ready in her tongue, ready in her ears, ready at home, in terms of food, in terms of everything. Whenever you see her, you become happy. That is a sign of a beautiful woman. And then Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِذَا أَمَرَهَا أَطَاعَتْهُ. Second beautiful quality from the woman, when you give them order, I want you to do this, I want you to stop doing that, she obeys. That is a beautiful quality. But so many challenges. Why and why? Why this? Why that? Why the other? so many whys today. You tell this or stop somebody doing that. Why this? Why me? Can you not see others? Only me, only our family. So many whys today, dear brothers. The third thing, the Prophet ﷺ said, وَإِذَا أَقْسَمَ عَلَيْهَا أَبَرَّتْ. Even if you take a swear that, wallahi, you will not do this, or do this, she will obey you. Eh? Lastly, dear brothers, the Prophet ﷺ said, إِذَا غَابَ عَنْهَا حَفِظَتْهُ فِي نَفْسِهَا وَمَالِهَا. When you are not there, she will take care of herself, and also take care of your wealth, of your children, not overspending, taking care of everything at home, taking care of your honor. If she lives badly, if she represents you badly outside, people will not say Khadija, Amina, Fatima, and this and that. They will say the wife of so-and-so. Did you see her on the street? Did you see the wife of so-and-so? So to take care of your honor, it is very important. My dear brothers, the deen of Islam, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, has truly encouraged the youth to get married. Ya ma'ashar al-shabab, man istata'a minkumul ba'ata falyatazawwaj. Whoever have the ability, financial ability, health ability, if you are able to sustain a home, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam should make an effort of getting married, because you are completing half of your deen. And also, my dear brothers, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَإِنَّهُ أَغَضُّ لِلْبَصَرِي. To take care of protecting your eyes not to look into haram. وَأَحْصَنُ لِلْفَرْجِ. And also to take care, and it takes care of your private parts. The Prophet ﷺ, according to the sunnah, if you do not have the ability, therefore perform fasting. Now dear brothers, today the Prophet ﷺ, he said, amongst the best weddings, the woman that is best blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is one whose demand is less. Inna a'zama an-nisa'i barakatan aysaruhunna ma'una. The Prophet ﷺ said, the woman that Allah will put barakah in their life, in their marriage, it is someone whose demands are less. Today, my dear brothers, wallahi, the demands are becoming so difficult. Some people are demanding for mahar 10,000, 20,000 pounds. And then the marriage itself, we will not do it until you pay 25,000 pounds, 35,000 pounds. The whole is costing 25,000 pounds. Somebody's coming with a helicopter, 10,000 pounds, paying some people to come and dance, 25,000 pounds. This and that and the other, and the Ummah of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are dying hungry, my dear brothers. Therefore, extremely important to make it simple and easy at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the easiest way. Some Sahabas did not have anything. The Prophet ﷺ told them, what do you have? Even little bit of Quran that you have, teach your wife. But today, dear brothers, it has become so difficult. In opposite, when marriage becomes difficult, zina becomes easy. At the time of the Prophet ﷺ, marriage was so simple, zina became very difficult. Today, my dear brothers, zina has spread everywhere. Why? Because some of us have put so much demand. No, you cannot do this. No, you cannot do that. How can you get married to my daughter and just pay little bit of this, little bit of that? And when you stand to the wife and tell her that let's just do little bit of this according to the sunnah, pay the rest of sadaqah, subhanallah. It becomes very difficult. It becomes the point of fighting at home. Therefore, dear brothers, if a home is built according to the sunnah of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless it. If the home is built with israf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala immediately said, Inna Allah la yuhibbul musrifin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not put barakah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said, Inna al-mubadhirina kanu ikhwana al-shayateen. Those people who do a lot of israf, these, thousands of that, thousands of that, ikhwana al-shayateen. You're only impressing shaitan, dear brothers. You are making marriage difficult to the youth who are encouraged by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Therefore, my dear brothers, very important that we follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Today our youth are imitating the non-Muslim. They want the big cake, they want the big suit, they want that, they want the other, the big hall, the big helicopter, the big car. It is becoming very difficult when you ask them, what are the rights of your wife? They do not know. What is nikah? They do not understand. What is talaq? They do not understand. They're so much busy with the dunya. The akhirah, dear brothers, takes second stage. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us in this life. and the life after he. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi.